Now.
Good evening, everybody. Hi, this is Sophia from Reflection Pond, and here is Christoph with his beautiful cello.
Hello, everybody.
So, welcome to this evening's live meditation, cello meditation, called Anything is Possible.
We just made sure we have the right microphone. Thank you, concert window, for confirming that we are looking and sounding good. That's always nice. So here we are in the mountains of Western North Carolina, coming to you live from our living room and bringing you guided visualizations. Tonight's theme is Anything is Possible. And that is a motto that we can use at any time to encourage ourselves on our path in life. There are many occasions we are working hard and going towards our dreams. There may be challenges that come up. There may be difficulties that come up. Whether it's in our environment, whether it's interactions with people, situations that we have in our lives, and our own thoughts, our own mental thoughts, doubts, fears, worries that create their own kind of obstacles. So this evening, I would like to remind all of us, also myself, is always a good reminder for myself, that thoughts are just thoughts. They are not a reflection of reality, not always. And oftentimes, thoughts can deceive us and bring us down. So let us encourage ourselves and remember that anything is possible, really anything is possible. No matter how difficult and how challenging things may get, there is a gift, there is a treasure. This is something I believe that helps me to go through difficult, challenging times in my own life. And I hope that this will also help you in any situation that you are in. Today is Tuesday. Just on Sunday, we had another concert window show right in our living room. That was Christoph's band, the Wilhelm Brothers, playing live a benefit concert to help a friend of ours who is dealing with cancer and all the medical costs with cancer. Concert Window gave us an opportunity to connect with people and bring music out to everybody and raise funds for Paul. This is another evidence, another symbol that anything is possible. There are people out there to embrace you with love and prayers and hope. So, you know, life is full of such examples. And a shout out to Concert Window itself. Not only did they contributed and showed their support to the cause, they are giving all of us an opportunity to bring our gifts out to the world. So anyone in the audience, if you are a musician or if you are a meditation teacher like myself, I invite you to do a live show. If you have not already done so, please take a step and do a live show. Invite a few people that you know and bring out your gifts out there. If you have already done a show or two, continue to do that. I've been doing this for the last 5 months. This is our fifth show, and it is very exciting to be bringing meditation out to everybody from our living room. So I encourage you to follow your heart and let go of the worries and the doubt and just go for it. Take the next step. So what follows now is this. Our event will be about 30 minutes, so around 9:30 or so we will wrap up, unless there is questions or requests from the participants. We will be very happy to have a conversation about meditation, about conscious living, any challenges you're facing, and we can talk about it and find hope, find solutions, and just express that. So you'll have a chance to do that at the end of the meditation. You can use the chat box to communicate with us. And for the next 25 minutes or so, you're in for a treat, especially because we have melodious music of the cello. Of course, I'm biased because it's my husband who plays the cello, and I do have that. But many of you know that music gets right to the heart, gets to the soul. And the cello tunes that Christoph will be playing to accompany our meditation will be meditative. It will help you to go deeper, to quiet your mind, to let go of those thoughts. Thoughts are normal part of any meditation practice. So instead of fighting the thoughts, let's just observe them. Because sometimes it may be that this is the first time you even get a chance to hear your thoughts. We are so busy with our lives and commitments and things to do that sometimes we don't even know what our own thoughts are. Whether or not they are good or bad, that's a secondary. At least let's get acquainted with our own mind, our inner world. So when you have thoughts coming, whether it's about what dinner I should eat, or I just ate, or what the day is going to look like tomorrow, or about something from the past or the future, let it be. There is nothing wrong with having those thoughts. Okay, so we'll embrace that. And I'm sitting right now in a lotus position, but you do not have to. You can sit any way that is comfortable. You can lay down. You can keep your eyes open or closed. There is no hard and fast rule about this, because I believe if your body is in a restricted position that you're not used to, your mind is going to focus on the body. So let's get that out of the way and be comfortable. Get yourself covers or turn on the fan, depending on what you need. The air conditioning, you know, just keep yourself comfortable. Temperature and position should be comfortable. But if you do choose to sit in any form of yogic position, lotus position, make sure that nothing is tight. You can, you know, relax your shoulders. Your back needs to be straight, but not tight, okay? You don't have to be like this. But just something that feels good. Also, you can relax your neck and you'll feel it loosening up. And anytime during the meditation, if you need to switch your position, go ahead, do that, okay? And we'll begin with some breathing. So let's get in our position. And I'm going to close my eyes. You're welcome to do so. And just bring awareness to your breathing. Just become aware of how you're breathing in and breathing out. Let your body become relaxed. Feel the tension, the stress, the tiredness leaving your body. Floating with the sounds of the cello, you're becoming relaxed and fluid. Relax the muscles on your face and your eyes. Start a gentle smile coming from your heart, coming from deep within. Just a gentle smile. Imagine all the cells in your body are smiling, are happy, are just giddy with love and good feelings. Imagine that you're sitting on a giant lily pad in the middle of a pond. And there are water lilies everywhere in this pond, floating along with you. And very slowly, this floating leaf, this floating lily pad, is submerging underwater. Slowly, it's going deeper and deeper to the bottom of this pond. there's a magical world under the water. The pond is filled with amazing creatures. Creatures with the most beautiful lights and shapes. Floating by, you just enjoy looking at these different life forms. And it sounds so different underwater. It's quiet, but you can hear everything clearly. Arrive in the bottom, you step out of the lily pad and walk on the sandy floor barefoot. You can feel the wonderful texture of the sand. Feel the grass, the pebbles, and you feel safe, you feel content in this beautiful place underwater. You start walking around and you look around yourself. A few yards down, at a distance, a short distance, you see a very shiny and glittery object. It's radiating. Pleasant light coming from this object. You start walking towards it, and you see that it's in the shape of a giant fish, a multicolored fish. It's actually rock, a rock that's carved into the shape of a fish. And it's beautiful. Its eyes are so beautifully painted, they look alive. And the mouth of the fish is open. It's actually the doorway inside this object. And without hesitation, you step inside the fish. The rock that is in the shape of a fish. and inside. It's an amazing, amazing place. It is a long tunnel, and on the walls of this tunnel are all signs and artifacts that symbolize your life, your dreams and your passions, things that you love to do, the wonderful things that you have said and done in your life already. Has images of all the wonderful people that are special to you and who love you. It's all the beautiful moments of your life. Makes you really happy, acknowledged and celebrated to be in here. And you just take a moment to look around at the amazing life that you have led. And as you look at the walls, suddenly there is a being that emerges in front of you. And this being has a very warm and kind, benevolent personality, benevolent energy. And this being looks at you with those wise and compassionate eyes. And you feel instantly embraced in love. You feel seen, recognized, and appreciated. This being invites you to sit in the center of this structure. There's a circle of rocks, and from the center comes a gentle, glowing flame, a small fire. And the fire is flickering. It's strong. And it's got healing powers. This fire is unusual. It's not an ordinary fire. As you look into the fire, you hear a voice. The voice says, "Throw into me all your fears, all your doubts, all your pain, all your hurts. Throw into me all the burdens that you have felt and all the challenges and obstacles and difficulties. Throw into me everything that is stopping you. Let that all dissolve in my fire so that you can be set free, so that you can create the life, the world that you want, a world of peace, a world of benevolence, recognizing the common thread among all of us, each and every human and each and every living being, from the blade of a grass to a spider to a bird, any animal or bird being that exists on this planet, and feeling the connection of love and unity throughout our world. Let this fire set you free. The being that is sitting next to you is your courage, your support. Have been freed from all that's holding you back. Energetically, you've created space. It is time to envision a world of possibilities. The fire slowly fades away, and from the same circle emerges a fountain of water. And as the water is coming out and sprinkling all around it, the water is calling you to envision a life of infinite possibilities, where any desire, any dream that you hold dear is coming true, coming into physical manifestation. Because if you can think it and you can dream it, then you can have it in the highest good of all. So now is a time to envision. Think of your dream. What do you most desire? Hold so close to your heart for yourself and for our world. This is the time to allow it to come forth. Just visualize how it feels when the dream has become a reality. What does it feel like? You feel happy. You feel content and peaceful. You feel like you have really made a contribution in meaningful ways to our world. See the people around you, your family, the friends, people you work with, or you study with, people in your community. What are they saying to you? Congratulating you, for your dream has inspired theirs. You feel infused with this immense energy and strength, this undeniable belief that what you want to create is truly possible. And you create it, you manifest, you bring it out into this world. Because as you follow your heart, you inspire others to follow their calling, their purpose. And now, it is time for you to return. Thank your guide, your being sitting next to you, for being there to guide you and support you. And thank the fire and the water for helping you release the obstacles and to envision possibilities. Thank you. Now you stand up and walk outside the structure, the fish that you've entered before. Your being, your guide, merges back into the walls, and you come outside, step outside the mouth of the fish, and walk towards the lily pad, the giant lily pad that brought you down to the bottom of the pond. You sit in the lily pad and slowly you are brought up above to the surface of the pond. very gently, you're coming back into the room you're sitting in and into your body, feeling content, feeling grateful and relaxed. Connect back with your breath. Take a slow, deep breath. Very slowly, bring movement to your body. And slowly open your eyes. Welcome back. So, that was an amazing journey. Hope that you were able to feel the calm and relaxation in this journey.
I could.
Yeah.
Thank you, Sophia.
Thank you, Christoph. So, if you have a chance to note down your thoughts, you're welcome to do that. And if you have any questions or comments about how this experience was for you, you are welcome to use the chat and write a message. Ask us a question or tell us how you enjoyed the whole experience. A lot of what I guide you through is visual, giving you visual hints and clues. But you may have experienced all kinds of other sensory experiences, not just the visual, but a sense of texture and smell and taste, or just sixth sense of energy, something that you cannot put words on, you cannot touch, you cannot really make it tangible. All of that is visualization. It's a broad term. So if you didn't see images, you still were able to meditate because you used all your other senses as well. So I invite you to check out my YouTube channel for more meditation videos, more of such guided journeys with cello music as well. And to stay connected with me, you can go to reflectionpond.com, and we'll be doing another meditation next month. So hope that you can join in for that. And again, the message for today is follow your heart. Imagine anything is possible. You can live and create your dream. So keep the faith, keep your head high, and go for it. All help is coming your way. Lots of love from the mountains. I see that there is a message. Yay. Peter writes, very good. Thank you. I had not expected this kind of experience. I'm working with a counselor on mindfulness and this fit with it very well. Wow, fantastic, Peter. I am so happy to read your comment. Thank you for writing just in time. So great. Great that you're doing mindfulness practices, and the guided journeys that we do, that you just experienced, are really a help in that, because you can direct your mind to a certain kind of thought, which is the guided journey. So you're doing great in helping yourself with mindfulness. Thank you so much for joining. I guess I'll give one more minute to see if there are any other comments from Peter or from other people. You're welcome to write a note there. And I just want to take a moment to thank Christoph for playing cello. Thank you.
You're welcome.
It really helped me to get into the zone and quiet my thoughts while I'm doing the guided journey. So that's really nice. Christoph usually plays indie folk rock, so it's amazing that he's playing, you know, kind of, should we call it new age? I don't know what the term would be, but really meditative music. And he also has classical background, so the cello and Christoph are just versatile, so thank you.
You're too kind.
Putting you on the spot there. thank you so much. Thank you, Peter. Thank you for your generosity. And I want to thank Concert Window for giving us the opportunity to connect with people and bring our guided visualizations out to people. So right from my living room. Oh, I know this one, Larry. My experience was very similar to watching Yellow Submarine. Ah, I started with the migraine and ended with peace. Woo, I love that. Thank you for such generous comments. Thank you so much. Ooh, my heart is just so happy right now. The whole time my eyes were closed, but I could feel our cat coming in, giving me a head bob on my hand. So I don't know if any of you had your eyes open, but the cat he's back in his house, but he likes to come out and show himself when we do live shows. So I think
he walked past a couple of times and the tail pointed
The tail
was moving through the screen, that's for sure.
So if you saw a tail, then you saw the cat, yeah, like a shark.
Yeah.
Wonderful. Wow, thank you again. I just feel so happy, and thank you for your comments so much. And continue to find peace, and I send you all lots of love and lots of prayers. Big kiss from the Western North Carolina Blue Ridge Mountains, and see you next time. Bye.
Bye.